Hello everyone, my name is Sumit. Welcome to my channel Sumit Tube. In this tutorial series, we will learn how to design beautiful apps using MATLAB App Design. We will start with the basics, like how to drag and drop components, edit their properties, and write callback functions. We will be designing all of our apps from scratch and explaining the process step by step, making it very easy to understand the design flow. First, we will learn about different components by creating some simple apps. Then we will design professional apps that include different components, private and public properties and functions. We will also cover some complex examples such as designing multi-window apps. After designing apps, we will learn how to make standalone desktop applications and share them with other users. They can install and run the app like any other app without needing to have MATLAB installed on their computers. I'll create a YouTube playlist including all the MATLAB App Designer videos. I recommend watching the videos in order so you don't miss anything. The MATLAB version I am using is 2023B, which is the latest version at the time of making this video. If you are using a different version, you may notice some differences, but the core functionality remains the same. So it does not matter which MATLAB version you are using. Okay, so let's get started. In today's lesson, we are going to learn about lamp. This is a component which can show different colors. It can be very useful to show different states of your app. Now here we have two components. We have a state button and this is our lamp. When the button is not pressed, the lamp is going to show this green color. Now if we click on it, the button is in pressed state and the lamp would show the red color. Now if we click on it again, this button on turns into released or unpressed state and the lamp is going to show this green color. So let's see how we can design this app. In a previous tutorial video, we have learned about state button in details. So please watch this video if you haven't done so already. I will attach the video link in the I button. Okay, first let's bring this lamp component. To get this, you have to go to this all to the bottom and then you can see a instrumentation lab. And this is where you can found lamp. Let's bring it here. As usual, it's come with a label. Let's delete this and make it bigger. This is our lamp. It comes with this default color green. Now remember, lamp does not have any value or on off button. It just has a one and only important property. This is the color. You can see the property here. You can see some value as well as this green color. Now let's talk about this color in details. MATLAB handles color using this RGB triplet. Actually, they are three element row vector. These elements are the intensities of the red, green, and blue components of a color. Hence, the name is RGB. R stands for red, G for green, and B for blue. Now the intensities must be in the range from 0 to 1. They can take any value ULU from 0 to 1. Now let me give you some example. If the R component is 1 and other components are 0, we got the color red. If the green component is 1, we get the color green. And if the blue component is 1, then we get the color blue. Now we can mix and match this color. For example, if we mix red and green, we get the color yellow. If we mix green and blue, we get this color cyan. And if we mix red and blue, we get this color magenta. Now, what happens if we mix all of these three colors? In that case, we get the color white. If we mix none of them, we get this color black. Now, for these conventional colors, by conventional color, I mean the eight colors I just have shown you, MATLAB provides color name as well as short name. That means you can use this RGB triplet or you can use this full color name or the short color name. Now short color name is actually just the first word for these colors except the color black. In that case, it uses the last letter. This is because to avoid confusion with blue. Both of them starts with B. That's why for blue, the short name is B and for black, the short name is K. Now you can use this column or RGB triplet value. There is another way. This is called hexadecimal color code. You can use also that. Now for custom colors, you have to either use RGB triplet or this hexadecimal color code. For example, consider this color. This is their RGB value. R is 0.85, green is 0.325, and blue is 0.098. And this is the hexadecimal color code. This is the default colors MATLAB uses for plotting. Actually, this is a screenshot I have taken from MATLAB documentation. Now, in case if you are wondering how this RGB triplet value maps to this hexadecimal color code, let me explain it to you. Now, this RGB color code, actually all of them are 8-bit value. Now, what would be the range? If all of these 8 bits are 0, then we get the 0. This is our minimum value. To get the maximum value, all 8 bits has to be 1 and we get the value 255. So, this is the maximum value. So, the actual range is 0 to 255. In hex, this is 0 to FF. But remember, MATLAB uses 0 to 1. That means it divides actual range by 255. Now, consider this color. This is their RGB value and this is the color is kind of orange and this is their hex value. This is the normalized vector, that means it is divided by 255. To get the actual value, we have to multiply it by 255. Then we get 217, 83 and 25 respectively for red, green and blue element. Now we have to convert these three numbers into hex number. If we convert these three numbers, we get D9 for red, 53 for green, and 19 for blue. And that's how we get this hex color code. But remember, we must have to use hash before the hex color code. And also, I am using here single code. You can either use single code or double code. Both of them are fine. But remember, they have to be either this character vector or string. Okay, let's bring this lamp close to its property tab so we can see easily. Now, this is the color. You can see 010. This is the RGB value as well as the green color preview. Now, if you click on this, you can see a window. It says standard colors. It has four rows of seven different colors. And then you got the recent colors as well as the preview. Right now, green is selected. That's why you can see the green color in this preview window. Now, if you check the last row, you can see this conventional color. When you hover your mouse over this color, you can see their RGB value as well as the color name as well as their short name. This is red, magenta, then yellow, green, cyan, blue and black, and this is the white color, and this is the default colors MATLAB uses for different plottings. When you hover over this, you can see their RGB values. Okay, now there is also another option. This is where you can find all the custom colors. You can see all of the colors here and you can see a color map here as well as a slider. Now, if you move this slider up and down, you can see the whole range of color. As you move over, you can see their RGB values. Now, if you click on a specific color, the lamp color would change and you can see their RGB value. Now, this RGB value is 0 to 1 range. That means this is the range MATLAB uses. Now, if you click on this drop-down menu, you can also see RGB value in this 0 to 255 range. This is the actual color values. There is also an option to see these hex values. Okay, let's go back to this custom colors and choose the color green. Okay. Now, if you go to this callback section, you can see lamp objects do not have callback properties. That means user cannot interact with this lamp. Now, if you run this program, you can see the lamp and you cannot interact with this one. That means if you click, nothing happens. You cannot change this color. So we need a component where user can interact and change this lamp color. For this, let's bring a state button. This is our state button. Okay, let's make it bigger. Let's change the font size to 24. Also, let's bring the lamp in the middle. Okay, now we are going to control the lamp color using this state button. Okay, so time to write callback function. So select this state button, then head back to callback, then add a value changed function. Click on this, and we are inside this button value changed function. This is where we are going to write our callback function. But first, as usual, let's understand some basics. Now, in our simple help, we have two components. One is state button, and another one is lamp. In a previous video, we have talked about this state button on where the state can be accessed using this value property. To access the value property, we have to use this app.button.value. Now, there are two states. When the button is not pressed, the value is 0. And when the button is pressed, this value is 1. Okay, for lamp, it has a property called color. To access this property inside app, we have to use this app.lamp.color notation, where lamp is the name of my component. If you have given different component name, you have to use that specific name. Now, to set the lamp color green, we have to use app.lamp.color is equal to Z. I am using here short name. You can use the full name green or RGB value or hex value. Actually, green is the default lamp color. To set the color lamp, we have to use app.lamp.color is equal to R. Now, in our app, when button is not pressed, the value would be 0 and we will set the lamp color to green. When the button is pressed, that means when the value is 1, we would set the lamp color to R, that means red. Okay, now we have two components. As I mentioned earlier, lamp does not have any callback function. We have to associate the callback function to our state button. Now, time to write this callback function. First, we are going to read this app.button.value into some variable value. Now, if the value is 0, that means when the button is not pressed, we are going to set the lamp color to green. Else, that means when button is pressed, the value would be 1 and we are going to set lamp color to red. This is our callback function. Okay, so we have completed writing our callback function. Let's see if this one works. Okay, right now button is not pressed and we are seeing the lamp color green. Now, if we click on it, button is in pressed state and we can see the color red. So that means it is working. Now, if we click on it again, it is in unpressed or release state and we can see the color green again. So that means it is working properly. Now, we are using the short name here. If you want, you can use this full name. It is fine. Now, let's run this program again. Okay, that means this one is working properly. Okay, now let's choose two different sets of colors. Go to this design view, click on this lamp, and go to this property. Now, click on it here. Now, let's go to this custom colors, and we will choose some. Okay, maybe let's choose this color. We can see the hex value. We can also get the RGB value. We can just copy these values and paste it in our code. But it's better to click on this hex code. In that case, you can copy it in your clipboard using Ctrl plus C command. Okay, we are going to use this. Now, when the button is not pressed, we can choose some gray color which kind of mimics this button is off. We can and check these colors in this row to find out a gray color which kind of mimics this off step. We can choose this color. Now remember this RGB value 0.8, 0.8 and 0.8. All of these components are 0.8. Let's choose this color. Now, if you see, it kind of give you the feel this lamp is off. Okay, now go to this callback function. Now, when this button is not pressed, we are going to use this gray color using this RGB value, which is 0.8, 0.8, and 0.8. And when the button is pressed, we are going to use this custom color using this hex value. Now, let's paste it using Ctrl plus V. But remember, you have to use single quote or double quote to wrap it. In that case, MATLAB would handle it using a character or a string. Now, let's run this program. Okay, here is our app. Now, the button is not pressed and it looks like this lamp is off. Now, if we click on it, we get this custom color. And if we click on it again, it kind of gives the feel that lamp is off. So, our code is working properly. That's all from today's video. Hope you have learned something new today. Let me know your thoughts about this tutorial series. Add your comments below this video. As usual, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. And I am going to catch you in the next video.